Peak of the week. Good Wednesday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austin Onick with a check of your forecast, which is much improved from what we saw yesterday. The cool temperatures are back, albeit briefly, but we will be seeing some fairly comfortable conditions as we go into the course of the next couple of days as temperatures rise into about the mid to upper 70s by next week as a new storm system down south of us begins to give us the possibility of warmer temperatures and the possibility of more rainfall. We'll talk about that coming up in just a little bit. Welcome to the show. If you've never been here before, this is our online video weather blog netcast, a good opportunity for you to be able to catch up on what's going on with the weather in and around the Mid-South. That's East Arkansas, West Tennessee, and Northern Mississippi. If you live around that tri-state area, we've got an update on the forecast there. Or if you don't want to stick around for the whole update, which we usually go about 10, 15 minutes or so on here, you can catch the forecast scrolling by in the blue bar, or you can go to WRHE.com/weather for the complete forecast update, and we'll give you the details on that. Drop your location, got any weather reports into the comments section. We'll read off some of those as we go along throughout the rest of the morning. Temperature, wind speed, cloud cover. A lot of you probably have some rain gauge reports from overnight in the backyard. If you've got that, drop them into the area, into the comments section, and we'll read those off as we head throughout the next couple of days. 71 for our high temperature yesterday. Again, just below normal, but still pretty warm for this time of the year as we went through the early days, early parts of the day on Tuesday. Numbers back in the lower 70s there. 61, our average low is 54, so a little bit above normal there. Record high for today, 87, last set back in 1984. Don't think we're going to come anywhere close to that today. Matter of fact, about 20 degrees or so below that into the rest of the day today. Officially, we picked up 0.04 inches of rain yesterday. It wasn't all that much. Did add to the total, though, of about 17.75 inches plus. We've gotten a decent amount of rainfall for the entire year, but it's been kind of a mini drought across the Mid-South thanks to the fact that we haven't gotten a lot of rainfall in the last few weeks. Now, that's caused some burn bans out there. If you haven't kept up to date with that, that list has changed. We'll bring you that information coming up here in just a little bit. Rest of the day, temperatures back into about the lower 60s. So if you're heading out the door to lunch today, jacket would not be a bad idea, again, to ward off that chill, or at least finding a nice place to have a notch on the patio where the sunshine is located, because you're going to need that with the temperatures just a bit brisk for today and those winds, again, finally calming down, across much of the rest of the Mid-South. Sunlight causing a bit of a lens flare on the camera from the Grove stage in the area of Oxford, Mississippi, on the University of Mississippi campus for this morning. A little brisk out there as students and teachers and everybody else on their way to various locations. Looking out over Poplar Pike and Germantown, temperatures back in the lower 50s at City Hall in Germantown. Winds a little breezy out of the north at about 12 miles per hour or so. Into Collierville, temperatures going back to about the lower 50s as well, and numbers again looking pretty good with that sunshine into and around the area for right now. Willie Combs, sunny West Helena, Arkansas, thanks for tuning in. 56 degrees at this point in time. Shakura, hope I'm saying that right. Pearson, forecast for Monday. Are we getting severe weather? We'll talk about that coming up in just a bit. Good question as well. Welcome to everybody else who's tuning in from across the area on the comments section. Glad to have you along for the ride for this early Wednesday morning. Delays looking back toward Memphis International Airport from our 240 and Airways camera. Nothing to report at Memphis International. A little breezy, clearing skies out there, but delays of 15 minutes or less reported at this time. And likewise, not seeing any problems across the continental United States. So very good news for air travelers out across the area for this morning. More information on that from our webpage, WREG.com/weather. Traffic, I-40, I-55 in West Memphis, Arkansas, moving along quite nicely, 51 degrees, mostly clear at the West Memphis Airport. High pressure moving our way and forcing our latest cold front to be making its way on out of the picture. So around that front and into the backside of that storm system, air around high pressure in the northern hemisphere rotates clockwise. So winds coming in from out of the north-northwest behind that, pushing that front away to the east. And again, you notice on this side of the front, that's where all the moisture is located. Back behind that front, lots of clear skies. You can see that clearing line making its way past Jackson, heading toward the Tennessee River and over northern Mississippi. So for Corinth, Mississippi, some parts of Oxford down toward Tupelo. You've probably got some more clouds in that area than the rest of the Mid-South, but don't worry, you'll be clearing up into the rest of the day. Rainfall basically east of I-65 heading into eastern Tennessee, dissipating as it goes. So if you're heading east of Nashville today, you may be playing catch up with some of that rainfall. But here in the Mid-South, not much of anything showing up at this point in time. So again, looking at some pretty quiet conditions out there for right now. Randy Lewis, winter gear, maybe not quite that cold, but it will be a little bit on the brisk side. We'll talk about that coming up. Mid to upper 40s to lower 50s on WeatherNet 3. Wind gusts from last night showing a 37-mile-per-hour wind gust in Tunica at the airport. 32-mile-per-hour wind gust at Arkansas State in Jonesboro. So pretty breezy as that front made its way across the Mid-South. And cooler and drier for this morning. Temperatures back in the mid to upper 40s to lower 50s. Late this morning, past about News Channel 3, live at 9, lower 50s. Heading into lunchtime and afterwards, back in the upper 50s to lower 60s. Maximum temperatures today. Keep in mind, again, we should be in the lower to mid 70s. We're going to be about 10 to 15 degrees below that for the rest of the day today. So high temperatures late this afternoon, only back in the lower to mid 60s, and that's going to be about it. So a very brisk day coming up across much of the area. Don't forget about Jim Jaggers, his forecast later on tonight on News Channel 3 at 10, lower to mid 50s there, and getting into very early tomorrow morning, brisk, and maybe call it chilly if you want to, lower 40s out there. Not seeing any signs of frost at this time, but we are moving closer to that average first frost date for this area of the country, which is roughly about Veterans Day. So anytime before that, through about late October, we could easily see some frost forming in parts of the area with very little notice. So please, if you got any plants outside, be prepared to move those things in or cover them up if you want to extend the growing season by just a little bit to be on the safe side there. Currently into the tropics, we usually go straight into the 7-day forecast. We're going to take a bit of a detour to set up the 7-day forecast to show you what's going on. Down across southern Mexico and Central America over the last few days, this storm system has been wandering its way to the west-northwest. Currently over southern Mexico, it's expected to emerge here over the Bay of Campeche in the southwestern Gulf of Mexico. As we go throughout the next several days, this is going to be coming up over and into the northwestern Gulf and curving its way back to the northeast. Now again, air around high pressure rotates clockwise, air around low pressure rotates counterclockwise. So as this goes up this direction, it's a good possibility we may see a lot of moisture-rich air returning to the Mid-South as this curves its way along the coastline. Now, it's not strong enough for a designation. It doesn't have a name. It's not a tropical depression. It's just a mess right now. But as it gets out over those warmer waters, it could deepen and strengthen. At least there's a small chance of it anyway. As it does, again, it gets more organized and gets deeper into the atmosphere. We may see more rain heading up this direction. And that's where we may see some problems coming up in the 7 to 10 day forecast. Not for today though. Temperatures again going back into around the lower to mid 60s for the rest of the day today, and looking at some very nice sunny skies out there for today. A little warmer into tomorrow. Plenty of sunshine across the Mid-South. Dry, very light winds out there, not a problem. And same thing for Friday. A couple of days ago we had some rain in the forecast. Took that out of there for right now because it looks like this system, as it gets closer to us, is going to be arriving along the northern part of the Gulf of Mexico if it goes that way in the next couple of days. That'll be our best chance of rainfall starting late Saturday, going into Sunday, and increasing again as we go into Monday and Tuesday. That'll be the best chances of rain for a lot of you getting to fall break, a lot of you heading back to school from fall break. Monday morning could be kind of sloppy with chances of showers and maybe a thunderstorms into and around the area for right now. Again, this is where we're going to be seeing the best possibility of rainfall into and around the area. So Chikura Pearson, forecast for Monday for severe weather. Right now, it doesn't look like it, but keep in mind, again, that is still way into the future. So as it gets closer and closer, we'll have a better idea as to what we'll be looking for in the risk of severe weather. At this time of the year, definitely possible, but again, nothing from the Storm Prediction Center at this time. So what we're looking at for the right now. Willie Walker, no more warm days. Well, we'll have a few of them out there as the storm system gets a little bit more organized out there for the time being for right now. Jarrah, Styles, Pennell, a lot of young boys camping in Linden this weekend. How should they pack? Again, what we're looking at for right now is pretty mild conditions back in the lower to mid-70s. Better chances of thunderstorms for campers on the latter half of the weekend as that system down south of us gets more organized. So outdoor camping, again, could be okay on Saturday, but I'd be watching for more chances of showers and thunderstorms from Saturday night into and around Sunday or so. So that's where we're going to be seeing better possibility of the activity there. So camping, may want to get, again, just a poncho to make certain you have the rainfall potential out there for right now. Thank you very much. Looking again at the possibility of some drier weather and maybe some cooler weather coming on through. Excuse me, looking toward the area as that tropical system leaves the Gulf and heads away from us, down into the lower 60s to lower 70s by the end of this next week, right before Halloween, just off this forecast away a little farther, about 2 weeks away. Some of the medium range models are showing a big dip in the temperatures coming on through for Halloween. So we could be looking at a very cold finish to October if everything holds. But once again, because that is so far in the future, going to kind of hedge our bets and watch to see what happens for right now. So for the current forecast, again, showing some showers by next Friday and some cooler temperatures coming on through. Whether or not that big downturn actually happens, keep it tuned to the weather experts and we'll keep you updated on what we're looking at for there. Now, for the rest of the tropics, heading to the East Coast, this mass of showers and thunderstorms as it gets a little bit farther off into the Atlantic is going to become what's called a nor'easter. It's a pretty vicious type of storm system which can ruin a lot of forecasts very quickly. So if you're heading anywhere from the Carolinas all the way back up into and around New England this weekend, not looking great for seeing the leaves as this storm could bring a lot of moisture on shore. Winds, colder temperatures, not great driving conditions. So nor'easter conditions could deteriorate very quickly. So please keep that in mind if you're traveling that direction. What's left of Tropical Storm Melissa is now a mass of disorganized rain and showers out across the North Atlantic. We have another system, well, had, past tense, just north of South America. That has since dissipated, no longer being tracked by the National Hurricane Center. Likewise, we talked about this yesterday, Tropical Depression number 15, just off the coast of Africa, that also has fallen apart. It's now a remnant storm. National Hurricane Center no longer tracking this one, but the one in the Gulf, that could be something different and much more potent in the area. So we'll be talking about that over the next few days. So keep it tuned to the weather experts and the National Hurricane Center for more details. No burn bans in the Mid-South at this time, so burning outdoors is prohibited, but as a caveat, you may want to check with your local fire department just to make sure that you're able to do so. Again, officially burn bans have been rescinded. Not in effect for the News Channel 3 viewing area. Columbia County in Arkansas, several counties in Mississippi, and three counties southeast of Nashville, right around Chattanooga, still have burn bans in effect for some parts of the tri-state area. So once again, if you're doing any outdoor burning, especially, say, barbecue pits, fire pits, anything like that for fall celebrations, please make certain you can have that because it just takes one spark to start a very big wildfire. Go to wreg.com/weather. This map and links to the information will be down below the forecast as we go throughout the next couple of days. We'll keep you updated on that. Tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock Mid-South time, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration will be issuing their winter forecast for the United States from the Climate Prediction Center. This is not open to the public. It is open to broadcast and science personnel and also government officials. We will be taking part in that teleconference, listening in at what's going on, and afterwards we'll post the information again on our website so you can see more about the official snowfall expectations, the temperatures, whether or not La Nina or El Nino are going to be causing problems with the forecast. We'll have all of that coming up into and around the area as we go into tomorrow. This week in climate change, the stifling of research especially at the United States Department of Agriculture, should be a warning to all other federal agencies, especially where climate change is involved. And again, a lot of that going on out there, a very telling investigation from NBC News. Talking about smart cities is not enough. Adapting the technology is not enough. Not just adopting it, but putting it into use. More information about what smart cities are doing to help battle climate change, not only in the United States, but around the world. And from the Conversation website, why some people continue to think climate change isn't real, even though the evidence and the mathematics and everything is still out there. These will be coming up on my social media pages over the next few days through the weekend. So if you'd like to know more about what climate change is all about and how it affects you here in the Mid-South or other places, keep it tuned to more for my social media pages, and we'll keep you updated on that. Next meetings, your opportunity to find out more about severe weather. These meetings are going to be the next ones coming up, taught by the National Weather Service in Memphis. They last about an hour, hour and a half, depending on how many questions are asked and answered. And again, they're totally free, paid for by our tax dollars. So a good opportunity to learn more about what to look for before, during, and after severe weather, what to call or text or amateur radio report. So the information you see out there in the Mid-South can be passed along to people like me and my colleagues here at News Channel 3, so we can tell everybody across the Mid-South what you're looking at. Your information could help save a life somewhere else. That's what volunteer storm spotters do. And if you'd like to become a storm spotter, these opportunities are open to you. Chasing storms, that's a much different thing, so once again, keep that in mind. The one for Memphis has been scheduled. This one, again, will be taught coming up Monday, November 4th. It was just added a couple days ago. Here's the catch. There's a limited amount of seating for a larger area like Shelby County in Memphis. If you would like to attend this event and you're in Shelby County in Memphis as a resident, great. Sign up for it. You have to register for this meeting. It's still free. You just have to sign up to reserve yourself a seat. That's all it is. It's going to be held at the Shelby County facility on Mullen Station Road, Monday, November 4th at 6:30 p.m. Your opportunity to learn more. Find out more at weather.gov/MEG, or can't remember that, just go to weather.gov, click on the Mid-South area on the map, and that'll take you directly to the National Weather Service in Memphis to get the details on all of that. All right, one more check of the forecast into the rest of the day today. We are looking at very mild conditions out there for right now. Not seeing any problems with plenty of sunshine. On the cool side, though, temperatures will be below normal for this time of the year, back into the lower 60s. That's it, and that's all. So that jacket would be a good idea, but forget the umbrella. You're not going to be needing that anytime soon. Looks pretty dry across much of the area. Questions, concerns, ideas, didn't get any piece of information out there and you'd like to know more about that, easy, drop me a line at austin.onick@wreg.com. Would love to have you along for the ride. If there's something on here you'd like to see, more satellites, more weather from around the world, or climate data, whatever it is, let me know, and we'll see if we can include that as part of our Weather Overtime netcast. We'll have more coming up on Live at 9, more on News Channel 3 at noon. Jim Jaggers has your forecast through the afternoon hours through News Channel 3 at 10, and Todd Demers will be back with you tomorrow morning, bright and early, on News Channel 3 Daybreak Thursday. Live and direct from downtown, thanks to everybody for checking in, your weather reports, and your comments for this morning. Really do appreciate it, and stay tuned for more with News Channel 3 on air and online throughout the rest of Wednesday and throughout the rest of the week. Thanks for joining us.